Have you all booked the day off work? Great, innit? Until Monday. My mic's... Oh, there,
there we go.
This song's called On Holidays.
I'm looking forwards and I'll have a looking back on it. Gonna take a lot of photos and prove we had the best of it. I'm only living in the present now, about a week a year. All I need is a long weekend until I get back to it. I sit in my desk with my stars.
Thank you. So you're glad you got your Thursday ticket then? You're here to see us, yeah? You're not just here to see British Sea Power, are you? You're enjoying this, aren't you? You know, a few years ago, we had one fan. And he died. So we wrote this. The autopsy began after the final farewell show. After yet another empty room, the singer stormed off home. Have there really been no words to what they'd done? Then the cornet player whispered in the ear of the trombone. He said, remember when we started playing shows with our cabal? We'd get a decent turnout at that place by the canal. And the crowd was always gathered by that man, the one who almost seemed to force them into giving us a hand. Then the snoozing young bassoonist felt his lip against a twitch. He said, you know what happened to that guy? They found him in a ditch. For they were the favorite, they were the favorite, they were the favorite. What he had heard, apparently he lived a life completely without care, and he'd consume his drink with such alarming zeal. And he smoked a pack of cigarettes along with every meal. The dancer said by 25 his heart began to fail. The fiddler could confirm his daily habit of cocaine. Well, his chest pains were so common, said the bass, that he always had to carry aspirin with him just in case. Then the blues art cleared his throat and solemnly he said, with his often quoted motto, which correct me when I'm dead. For they were the favorite, they were the favorite, they were the favorite man of a dead man. Yeah, they were the favorite, they were the favorite. Drummer stood before them all to share what he had heard. Apparently he lived a life completely without care, and he could do his thing with such alarming zeal. And he smoked a pack of cigarettes along with every meal. That night during our show, about halfway through, he slipped away. He just stumbled out until the night they found him the next day. The band all sat in silence until later on the bus. When the writer set out, did this man identify with us? The accordion played a broken chord and spoke. He said, I don't know, maybe it was something that we wrote. At the station, as they said their last goodbyes and parted ways, there was a feeling that the years together, well, they hadn't been a waste. For they were the favorite, they were the favorite, they were the favorite band of the Jet Man. Yes, they were the favorite, they were the favorite. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. By the way, it's Joe Forshaw's birthday today. Give him a cheer.
19. He looks good for 19, doesn't he?
Happy birthday, Joe Forshaw. Happy birthday to you.
What a guy. His family's there. They bought 3,000 tickets to get it.
This is all my cousins, mate. It's Catholics.
Me and him have been playing together for such a long time. We used to do weddings and stuff. One time we did a wedding, and there was a load of fucking Tories at it, and they ruined it. So we wrote a song about it. And this is it. So I know Tories ruin everything. Don't let a Tory get into you this weekend. Don't let them take it away from you. Since you've earned it, all right? Their breakfast. Now some of them are getting restless. You lead your new wife to the dance floor. Well, your first dance shouldn't be ignored.
Well, your family were aghast at the choice you made. They pictured someone else.
They think she's a mistake. Now she's yours.
Cheshire grippers who mocked the speech made by her father and the way she threw her garter.
I'm under control. We're all right, aren't we? It's lovely to be in these fabulous surroundings, but... You all right?
Yeah, I can't hear it. Can you have more organ?
Yeah, we've sorted it.
Can I have less guitar while we're at it? But I'd hate to come here and not sing you a song about where we're from, so this is that. It's called Distance Runner. I was sitting in a carriage on my way to see a concert, and I was looking out the window through my reflection in the dirt. In a blur I saw factories, straight rows of trees, a message on a wall to rival fans. And then I thought of those departed, and knowing that there is no heaven, I thought no other ragged region could ever make me smile and think of them. If you wanted to suss me out and sum me up, then follow me down to a route by a brook, over the railway, under the barbed wire, along a pathway that's made of desire, singing songs that were too young to call you. Close up a rope and see your marks in the sun, but I know to be true, whatever I do, wherever I exited the station, I pulled my scarf over my nose and swiftly altered my direction. Forgoing music, I heard melodies, a song I'd beneath, changed to faded like a can of crisp bags and leaves. Over the bushes and past the old dams, I broke to a jog before jumping the fence, singing songs that were too young to call you. Close up a ball, see a lark, sing a song that I know to be true. Whatever I do, wherever I run, the landscape remains, but I guess I'm gonna or be a runner. I'll look back into forever and ever, but I don't expect you to understand. Yeah. You're all a bit spread out. I'd like it more if you... It's better... It's not just better for me if you come forward, it's better for you. So, do think about bunching up a little bit. It's not a command, it's just, you know... A bit of advice, because we're going to make you dance now. We're going to make you dance to the disco beat of a song based on a 1950s French essay on margarine advertising and how that transpires into Woo! The way government sell us all their fucking lies, am I right?
pacify the rebel. And call it Operation F-A-R-G-O.
Thank you so much. It's and this is going to be our last tune. We had two more planned, but apparently, have we been long? I don't know. Not our fault. Ask for your money back. So it's going to rain. Just let me prepare you for that. I want you to raise your V's to the sky. Until the sky, like a scally on bonfire night, I don't give a fuck. Thank you very much, we're Man on the Echo.
Don't care if your pasta's al dente. Don't care what you're having for your tea. And I don't wanna come to your party. But I don't give a fuck what you reckon. I don't give a fuck what you reckon. I don't give a fuck what you reckon. No, I don't give a fuck what you reckon. Don't care about your occupation. Don't care where you took your vacation. Don't care if you split from your lover. I don't care if you're round with your mother. And I don't give a fuck what you reckon. I don't give a fuck what you reckon. About Labour, don't care what you think of the Tories, don't care what you think of your neighbour, or for your subconscious allegories. And I don't give a fuck
what you reckon.
I don't give a fuck what you reckon. I don't give a fuck what you reckon. No, I don't give a fuck what you reckon. Don't care about the thing that you just read, if I did I'd have read it for myself. Don't care about the programme you just watched, or how long you've been at the bus stop. And I don't give a fuck
what you reckon.
I don't give a fuck if you're
what you reckon.
I don't give a fuck if you're
what you reckon.
Kendall, I don't give a fuck
what you reckon.
Don't care if you're having a cocktail. Don't care if you're having a real egg. Don't care if you're switching to brown bread. And I don't give a fuck what your kid just said. And I don't give a fuck
what you reckon.
I don't give a fuck what you
what you reckon.
I don't give a fuck what you
reckon.
No, I don't give a fuck what you
reckon.
I say I don't give a fuck what you
reckon.
Yeah.
Kendall. Have a great weekend.